in my head, but I won't let them win. It's my time and it's definite. I will never miss.
Put your rollie in your pocket. The jack is a pocket watch and blow arm robbers to NASA. I walk with a rocket launcher. I awkwardly talk to God. Father, I'm not a monster. I'm a product of this block.
Kendrick Lamar is that guy. What's going on, YouTube? Listen. No long intros today. The internet has been going wild. You guys have been mad hitting me up about this. Kendrick Lamar has gotten on a Future track, and you guys are saying that he has dissed J. Cole and Drake. Now look, I don't know if this is another Control type verse where it's in the spirit of competition in hip hop, or if he is really coming for next and he has actually chosen violence. We're gonna find out right here, right now. But before we get any further, listen, I want to give a quick shout out to the website, guys. Official merch on there. Get your hats, get your hoodies, get whatever gear you want. If you like what you see, you want to support the channel directly, I'll put all links to check that out below. But anyways, no, we're here for Kendrick Lamar. Step up to the plate. Let's see what you got. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, I know that sample. Shout out to Mixtape Wheezy Days. Wayne has covered this one before.
Gotta buy my joint up on this bitch. I miss you. 3 times. Yeah. Sticking to the code, all these hoes for the street. I put it in her nose, it's gonna make her pussy leak.
Put it in her nose is going to make it come out the other end, but she's for the streets. I mean, if anyone's going to give us that quote, it's Future. Sometimes you just got to set the hoes free. Just let them go. Let them fly.
These hoes for the street. I put it in her nose. It's going to make her pussy leak. Pussy niggas told ain't going to wake up at they sleep. You can't hear that switch, but you can't hear them niggas scream. All my hoes are strong, nigga. All my hoes are...
Can't hear the switch, but you can hear the screams. The switch that takes it and converts it from a semi to an auto.
Can't hear that switch, but you can't hear them niggas scream. All my hoes do shrooms, nigga. All my hoes do coke. 20 karat ring, I put my fingers down her throat. If I lose a carrot, she might choke. I know she gon' swallow, she'll go. Free band, nigga, bring them red.
I've said this before, it's goat behavior. Ladies, you know, whether it's spit or swallow, if you swallow, it enhances your teeth. It's good for you. You get a little vitamin D in your system for the day. Swallow more. It's the American way.
I know she gon' swallow, she'll go. Free band, nigga, bring the rats in. Got shooters in the corner, light a pack in. She think Kusha's out of bitch, she a track, yeah. That's that shit that get you put up at the station. And the model's still the same. Fall like I won a championship game. You know these hoes hungry, they gon' fuck for a name. I put her on the game, she get fucked for a chain. Got your girl in this bitch, she twirling on the dick. I got syrup in this bitch, turn up in this bitch. And we bout to irks in this bitch, you murked in this bitch. All these pointers on me, baby, you know it's game time. Bring a friend, bitch, we fuck with mess.
All these pointers on me, you know it's game time. Like, it's all on him. Point it to him, pass him the rock versus, like, he's rocking the diamonds and the way that he's shining right now.
All these pointers on me, baby, you know it's...
I mean, look, what you get with Future, right? You get the sex, you get the drugs, you get the violence, you get it all, right? This man just leans heavily into that. It's like, feels so good to be so bad. Devil may care type of attitude.
It's about the irks in this bitch, you're murked in this bitch. All these pointers on me, baby, you know it's game time. Bring a friend, bitch, we fuck them at the same time. I'm a different nigga, no, we not the same kind.
Well, you can get that 2-for-1 discount if you bring a friend.
At the same time. I'm a different nigga, no, we not the same kind. You can have that look, bitch, you ain't mine. Young dope, dealer selling dope, is you like that? Kicking doors, kicking in doors, is you like that? Young throw, nigga selling lows, is you like that? All 24, you won't go, is you like that? Niggas from the bottom really like that. Stepping in Balenci's if you like that. Pop another bottle if you like that.
Yeah, that is sampled so much. He once was a thug from a shout out to Eazy-E, man. Going back to that original sample, but I've heard that chopped and just dropped into all kinds of production throughout the years, man.
These niggas talking out of their neck. Don't put no coughing out of your mouth. I'm way too paranoid for a threat. Hey, let's get it, bro. D.O.T., the money, power, respect. The last one is better. Say yes, a lot of goofies with a check. I mean, I hold them sentiments symbolic. My temperament bipolar, I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem. out, but pay not be legit, no 40 water, tell them, aww. Yeah, get up with me, fuck sneak this, and first person shooter, I hope they came with three switches, I crash out like fuck rap, this Melly Mel if I had to, got two T's with me, I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos, it's up, lost too many soldiers not to play it safe, if he walk around with that stick, it ain't Andre 3K, think I won't drop the location, I still got PTSD, motherfuck the big three, nigga, it's just big me, nigga, boom, what? I'm really like that, and your best work is a light pack, nigga, Prince outlive Mike Jack, nigga, boom. For all your dogs getting buried, that's a K with all these nines. He gon' see Pet Cemetery, nigga.
Rhyme dope, dealer selling dope. Is you like that?
I didn't think it was real. I thought I was being lied to. I thought you guys just... Cat Williams started 2024 on a different type of note. We've been on that diss track season energy left and right. I thought, you know what? No, there's no way. There's no way. We just got Kendrick Lamar Control 2.0. Except in this case... it feels a lot less like friendly competition. I just wanted to let that verse play out. Now we're going to break it down. Because that is not... there's no indirects. There's no friendly competition about this one. This is coming straight for the neck. And you know exactly who he's talking about. There's no, this is a subtle innuendo. This could go this way or the other way. No. No, this is not fucking subtle. He might as well just have said their name.
Two T's with me.
All right, let's start from the top. Wow. We on a different type of energy, Kendrick.
These niggas talking out of their neck. Don't put no coughing out of your mouth. I'm way too paranoid for threats.
So he's too paranoid, but he's going to fire back. Don't pull that coughing out of your mouth. Like, you're running your mouth, and that's going to lead you to the coffin, right? Talking about who? See, because later on, it's Drake and it's J. Cole. With the first person shooter line. So now I'm going to break down this verse because I feel like everything is set up leading to that. So he's firing shots even here at the beginning at Drake and Cole. Listen.
These niggas talking out of their neck. Don't put no coughing out of your mouth. I'm way too paranoid for threats. Hey, let's get it, bro. DOT, the money, power, respect. The last one is better. Say yes, a lot of...
the money, power, respect. That's another symmetry line because later on he talks about the big three. In first person shooter, J. Cole talks about the big three within his verse, being Drake, being Kendrick Lamar, and being J. Cole. And then J. Cole says that he feels more like Muhammad Ali. You know, he's one of the greats, but he's the greatest of the greats in that sense. And that's more in the competitive spirit of hip hop. But Kendrick flips it later on. But for me, there's a little bit of that big three subtly slipped in here. Money, power, and respect. I'm the latter of this. And then later on, the big three takes on a different connotation. He starts...
hey, let's get it, bro. DOT, the money, power, respect. The last one is better. Say yes, a lot of goofies with a check. I mean, I hope them...
this is when it really starts breadcrumbing out. A lot of goofies with a check. He just called Drake goofy, right? Drake has a deal. He's got a sub-label with Nike. Nike, the check, the swoosh, versus like being verified, versus like getting the checks. J. Cole and Drake versus... they both have checks.
The last one is better. Say yes, a lot of goofies with a check. I mean, I hold them sentiments symbolic. My temperament bipolar, I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up.
I mean, he really woke up and chose violence. And listen, the Kendrick Lamar Drake beef goes way, way back. Speaking of Control, isn't it funny? Not too long ago, we broke down Control and now we're getting this. But, you know, Kendrick talks about Drake on Control. And most artists heard Control and they're like, yeah, that's Kendrick talking his shit in the spirit of competition. That's what hip hop is about. And it was a friendly, competitive type of way. There was one artist who really felt a different type of way about Control, and that was Drake. And Drake started just having subtle little jabs at Kendrick in interviews, saying stuff about him, right? And then Kendrick decides to fire back about this rapper who gets in his feelings all the time, who doesn't, you know, has this chip on his shoulder, can't take things in the spirit of competition, gets all in his feelings, and then back and forth we go. And this has been happening for years. So I feel like this has just been bubbling up. And if you look at Kendrick, you're like, hang on. All right, we get why he's firing at Drake, but why fire at Cole? And I think because of the affiliation. Drake and Cole are going on tour together, right? Cole's going to make appearances on the tour. They've done this track together. They're talking about the GOATs. They're shouting out Kendrick on the track. And I just feel like Kendrick is like the nerve of these motherfuckers. Like, Cole must know that I do not like this dude. And now he's running around on tracks with them and they're name dropping me on this track. I can see why Kendrick is taking offense. But There's more here. Let's keep going.
I'm way too paranoid for a threat. Hey, let's get it, bro. DOT, the money, power, respect.
The last one is better.
Say yes, a lot of goofies with a check.
I mean, I hold them sentiments symbolic. My temperament bipolar, I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem. Niggas clicking up, but pay not be legit. No 40 water, tell him.
That's a dope E40 bar, but before that, right? Before that, I'm trying to figure out if that's Drake or that feels like Cole that long. Time for him to prove that he's a problem, right? Because J. Cole runs around bragging about, you know, he's the feature killer. He's the best. You don't want beef with him. You don't want this. That happens in a lot of J. Cole related songs, right? So I wonder if Kendrick is like, I'm going to put the pressure on him now. I'm going to directly apply the pressure. Because if we go back and we listen and we did a breakdown of Black Friday as well, right? We did that. I do feel like Kendrick had the better verse over the J. Cole beat versus J. Cole rapping over the Kendrick beat. I do feel like Kendrick had the better verse on that. So Kendrick, I feel like, is like, I'm going to apply pressure now. And we're really going to see if GOAT status is going to rise up, if Cream is going to rise to the top or not. Or he could just be talking about Drake and applying pressure because Drake is running around wheelchair Jimmy acting all gangster like he's doing this, like he's doing that when, you know, there's different facts to Drake's life and his come up.
My man bipolar, I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem. Niggas clicking up, but pay not be legit. No 40 water, tell him.
Right, so this bar right here is a really dope E40 bar because he talks about can't be legit. Like, they're not legitimate versus Be Legit, who is E40's cousin. And E40 and Be Legit have a hip-hop group with some of E40's family called The Click. So these dudes are clicking up, a.k.a. J. Cole and Drake are clicking up together. They're joining up together, but they still can't be legit. Yeah, like I said, that's what Kendrick Lamar is taking offense to. The fact that Cole is teaming up with someone who Kendrick Lamar does not like and definitely views, I would say, as a rival in this sense. And then again, it's the nerve to name drop Kendrick on it.
Symbolic. My temperament bipolar, I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem. Niggas clicking up, but pay not be legit. No 40 water, tell him.
And then like clicking up, like they're trying to come through. They're trying to stay strapped, but they're not really strapped as they're clicking up.
Time for him to prove that he's levels. A problem. Niggas clicking up, but pay not be legit. No 40 water, tell him.
No 40 water. I could take it. I could take that in a number of ways because E40's drink 40 water, right? That was supposed to be like, he was like kind of trolling with that. He was joking with that drink and he talked about even bringing it back one day and he made a song 40 water and played off of 40. But then 40 water was supposed to be like, you know, alternate version being healthy to having an alcoholic drink. So y'all are like watered down. Y'all aren't really coming through with the bars, right? Y'all come through with that fake health.
He's a problem. Niggas clicking up, but pay not be legit. No 40 water. Tell him. Yeah, get up with me. Fuck sneak this. And first person shooter. I hope they came with three switches. I crash out like fuck rap. This Melly Mel if I...
hope they came with these switches, right? I hope they came with the autos on this case. And they better come through and watch who they're counting, right? But first person shooter is the song. Y'all are not first person shooters. Clicking up, see the connections and see what he's doing here. This is not subtle at all.
First person shooter, I hope they came with three switches. I crash out like fuck rap. This Melly Mel if I had two. Got two T's with me. I'm snatching.
And then I feel like Eminem got a shout out there. I'm crashing out like fuck rap. Like, I don't really give a fuck at this point in time, right? I'm not here. Like, to me, again, this is almost like, this is the opposite. Like, this is the Kendrick being bipolar, waking up, choosing violence, that devil on his shoulder he finally gave into, right? Because he's no longer doing the spirit of competition to me. Like, this is ruthless. Like, fuck it. I'm coming for next now. Like, fuck rap. If Melly Mel even disses me, someone who's a, you know, one of the pioneers of hip hop, one of the OGs, I would diss him too, like Eminem. Right? I would go after him too. I don't give a fuck at this point in time. If you want to sneak this, you want to run around. And now I want to go back and reanalyze first person shooter and think about what Kendrick thinks the sneak dissing is going on with him in that.
These switches, I crash out like fuck rap. This Melly Mel if I had two. Got two T's with me. I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos. It's up. Lost too many soldiers. Not-
two T's, that's his bodyguard, so he's ready for it. He's ready for war.
Who got two T's with me? I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos. It's up. Lost too many soldiers not to play it safe. If he walk around with that stick, it ain't Andre 3K. Think I won't drop the...
And that line, like if his bodyguard walks around with the stick, Right, you know what's on. It's a different type of sick. We're not talking about Andre 3000 making his flute records. Everybody's all excited. Andre's dropping an album. We'll finally get that first solo album from Andre 3 Stacks, one of the greatest MCs of all time. No, we get flute records. But no, Kendrick's not walking around with a flute in this case. He chose that violence.
Got two T's with me. I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos. It's up. Lost too many soldiers not to play it safe. If he walk around with that stick, it ain't Andre 3K. Think I won't drop the location. I still got PTSD. Motherfuck the big three. Nigga, it's just big me. Nigga, boom.
What? That line right there. Motherfuck the big three. I love how he just like slows down the flow and gets more staccato with the delivery, man. I haven't even talked about the delivery because I'm just trying to break down these bars. But that big three line is a direct reference to J. Cole's verse. And again, this is why it's like, it's not just Drake. It's not just Drake. Because that big three reference is what J. Cole used on First Person Shooter. You see how Kendrick is connecting all this? Fuck them. He just said fuck them. Fuck Drake. Fuck Cole. It's me. Only one. I'm one A, B, C, D from here until infinity, right? You can count that out.
It ain't Andre 3K. Think I won't drop the location. I still got PTSD. Motherfuck the big three. Nigga, it's just big me. Nigga, boom. What? I'm really like that. And your best work is a light pack. Nigga, Prince outlived Mike Jack. Nigga, boom.
Your best work is a light pack. Prince outlived Mike Jack. Now, that to me is for Drake, right? Drake is like a Michael Jackson. Pop stars, sold all these records, has all this success. Kendrick, affirming himself, attaching himself to Prince. Kendrick even tried to have Prince on to Pimp a Butterfly, right? He was in studio with him. They got talking. Kendrick said they ran out of time, unfortunately, but he's always looked up to Prince, right? Because Prince is a more timeless artist, right? That's the argument of Prince over MJ, even though they have a lot more in common than they do have against each other, but they had an iconic beef, right? There was the Brown concert, wasn't it? When Michael went up on stage, then Prince went up on stage, and like the crowd was more into Michael, and then Prince started doing wild stuff, like tricks with the microphone stand, and then he tried to like swing off to the side, and he pulled like part of the props down, and like Michael was like, it was embarrassing afterwards. Michael Jackson even went and bought the footage to make sure it would never get buried so we could have it as like blackmail. Yeah, this is a long-standing feud between those two. So I think Kendrick is positioning it as, you know, he's Prince, making timeless art and more known to be an artist versus someone who just has popular mainstream success and stacks records even though they're talented, right? And Prince also literally outlived MJ, and Kendrick is saying he's going to outlive Drake in this case. There's a big flip as well.
Like that, and your best work is a light pack. Nigga, Prince outlived Mike Jack. Nigga, boom! For all your dogs getting buried, that's a K with all these nines. He gon' see Pet Cemetery, nigga.
And then the bars to finish it. I mean, that's just ridiculous. The K9 like a dog, K9 teeth, K9 dog versus the K with the nines. He's K-ing them with the nines that he's bringing. And even the boom sounds like a gun firing off when he does sort of that little effect within the ad-lib right there. And For All the Dogs is the album that Drake dropped. So there's even more breadcrumbs. And then he flips that For All the Dogs, in this case, with the K9 bars, with he's going to turn it to a pet cemetery. He's going to bury you in the cemetery for pets versus the Stephen King novel and the horror movie Pet Cemetery, when these motherfucking pets are coming back to life and he's resurrecting the dead and just dropping bodies right now.
Your best work is a light pack, nigga.
Man!
Outlive Mike Jack, nigga. Woo! For all your dogs getting buried, that's a K with all these nines. He gon' see Pet Cemetery, nigga.
I'm dope, dealer selling dope, is you like that? Kicking doors, kicking in doors, is you like that? Young throw niggas.
This is a turning point.
Lows, is you like that? All 24, you want.
I mean, even the decision to get on a track with Future and Metro Boomin, there's a lot of rumors that Future is beefing with Drake. We know that Metro Boomin has been beefing with Drake. They've had little jabs throwing at each other. You know, when the Metro Boomin album was up against Drake's album, then Drake's album won it. Metro Boomin made that tweet that, you know, the award shows are more about politics and popularity contests. But then he deleted it later on. Drake comes out later. And then he talks about those tweeting deleters and all that and throws his subtle jabs. So they've been going back and forth. So this is another chess move from Kendrick. I'm going to get on a track with someone who's feuding with Drake, because I know what that means. I'm moving pieces. And Kendrick, like he said, Cole wants to click up with Drake, right? And his enemies, and move chess in that way. Well, I'm going to move chess in this way. I'm going to click up with Metro Boomin and Future, and then we're going to see where the smoke settles on this.
Like that. Young throw, nigga selling lows. Is you like that?
All 24, you on go as you like that. Niggas from the bottom really like that. Stepping in Balenciaga.
I don't even give a fuck about this hook at this point.
Like that. Pop another.
My mind is spinning.
Bottle if you like that.
Dope switch up.
Young dope, dealer selling dope.
Metro Boomin just had to sauce it right
is
there.
Is you like that? Kicking doors, kicking in doors. Is you like that? Young throw nigga selling lows. Is you like that? All 24, you won't go. Is you like that? Niggas from the bottom really like that.
See if Kendrick says anything on an outro.
Stepping in Balenciaga if you like that. Pop another bottle if you like that.
Bangin' dope niggas was John slangin' powder. Walk in a strip club, make it rain for 3 hours. Locked in and now I got my phantom in my driver. Perked out, took chances in my hood like Nevada. Surfed out outside white.
I wonder if the he once was a thug now. Like if they're trolling Drake with that bar. Wow! Well, this is not something I had on my bingo card for hip-hop for this year. I tell you what. I think Cole needs to respond. See, this is the thing about Cole, though. He doesn't really get involved in these diss track beefs. Like, he'll throw his shots and his shade, and then he'll, you know, take more of the pacifist approach. He'll try to link up and collab and work together on things, and maybe that'll happen. Maybe he'll reach out to Kendrick, and we'll get, like, Black Friday 2. I don't know, but the door has definitely been opened up for Cole to say something, because this to me from Kendrick, like I pointed out, it's not just friendly competition. Yeah, there's still that competitive element, but Kendrick obviously took some offense and Kendrick obviously felt a type of way. So this is Kendrick laying down the chess move. Ball's in your court. What are you going to do? I mean, you know, we've not had something like this in a long time. We've not had two top tier MCs going at each other. Right? That doesn't really happen. Normally, a lot of these beefs are one-sided. We get surprises. I get it. But, you know, not since like the Jay-Z and Nas days and the King of New York shit and all that going on, Hot 97 and that beef and getting Ether. You know, we haven't seen this. We haven't seen this. So will we see it? I don't know. This would be fucking huge, though. That's all I'm going to say. I'm not even counting Drake. I don't know who's going to write his disses for him. But, you know, I mean, the door's open for Drake, too. Drake and Fireback as well. We will see where things go from this. Kendrick definitely chose violence. You were not so certified. Hope you guys liked today's video. Listen, if you're here at the end, obviously enjoying the content, do me a huge favor, support channel directly, subscribe, notifications on. Really, really does go a long way. I love you guys. Stay safe, stay positive. It's only Noxo. You know, I'll catch you again.